Right, good afternoon everyone. As you can see, it's not still day just today. We normally chair the meeting Thursday at the local government meeting. So I'm standing in for him. So we have to talk with me for this afternoon. Right, have you got any, can I first of all welcome two new people to the meeting. Chief Superintendent John Martin. And then Paul Murphy, John is Chief Superintendent of Police, and Paul Murphy from Merseyside Fire and Rescue Service. I mean, if you don't know them or you want to talk afterwards, have a word with them or anything like that, we'd love to do it now. I think everyone else knows one another. Okay. Also, I think we've got a visitor.
Yeah, I'm Sharon.
Welcome, Sharon. Okay, has everyone got the minutes of the meeting from Tuesday, the 25th of March? Yep. Can I accept those? Was it? Well, anyone who was there, could I? True record of the meeting? Okay, can I right, item four that is my fault. Yeah, I'll go back, yes, apologies, and there is Phil Davis to start with, yes. Thank you. Anyone else? Okay, thank you. Right, item four, terms of reference, starting on page three. Fiona, do you want to?
Thank you, Chair. Just because of awareness, we regularly review our terms of reference, and if you recall, at a recent meeting we agreed to extend our membership, and so the changes and revisions to the terms of reference reflect that, and as Councillor Smith has said, we are pleased to welcome representatives from police and from fire and rescue. We will be looking to secure a representative from housing, and obviously also we have written to Job Centre Plus to invite them to send somebody on as well. So
just put a slightly more up-to-date copy of the Safeguard Levels Partnership Board report on the tables. Still not complete, but further forward than the copy that's in with your board agenda. Key change, obviously we've got the comments from the board chair, so that's quite important to see. Within the constitution of this board, the Health and Wellbeing Board, there is receiving from the Safeguard Levels Board the annual report, and we've got a 2-year annual report. At this stage, as I've mentioned, it's still in draft, so there is very much an opportunity for the board, this board, to ask questions about the content. Not now, but there is an opportunity whilst people have been able to absorb what's in there, ask questions, and really have an opportunity to shape what the final report looks like. So I thought it was important to bring it along at the date that we'd previously agreed, and for that to give people an opportunity for some input. But if people have initial reflections on the report, then obviously we're happy to take those down, but equally happy for people to come back to me in the next few weeks with any comments or views about the report, so that I can then feed those back to the chair and we can revise the report in line with people's views and recommendations. Thank you.
If you want to ask again, to the stage, you have to read the report.
It's nice to have you here together, and then the final report back to you.
What I'd like to do is ensure that we've got a final report to go back to the Safeguarding Adults Partnership Board in the next month or so. So it hasn't been received all by that board as yet. So again, due to meet at the end of the month. So I think within the next week or so will be helpful in terms of comments.
Move on to item 6, and that's the Health Watch Annual Report.
Thank you. Had to submit our annual report by 30th of June, which meant we just slightly missed the cut-off date for this meeting. So no presentation, but there is a copy in front of you. It looks a lot better in colour, so you can get it from our website. Thank you, Lindsay, for doing that for us. We have to meet certain reporting requirements every year, which you can see in the reading report. This was our first year, as I'm sure you're aware. So most of that is, this is what we've done, this is how we've tried to meet our requirements the first year. It's fairly brief, fairly to the point. Next year will be significantly more substantial. We're now working to those statutory requirements as our KPIs effectively. If any of the organisations around the table can see ways that Health Watch can work with them to meet some of those requirements, please let us know. And likewise, if you can help us meet some of those requirements, we put it in a call through me, or you can talk to the manager, Health Manager, Aaron White. That's it. That's the brief description of what we want to get.
Do you
efforts so far to try and place our work around what we're hearing from the public rather than what we think is most appropriate. There's really past the finish groups now running on specific topics. Access to GPs is one. I think that's just about the first part of the report. There's been some work going on around the AE department. And you'll have to give me a third one on there. But those reports will go to the relevant bodies. The only thing I would stress, I suppose, is around the local course, all those task force groups are being